Russia's invasion of Ukraine during World War II left my maternal grandmother, Paraskevia Mikhnyak, alone to care for my sick aunt in Western Ukraine. My grandfather, having already been arrested once, had to flee from the Stalinist regime. My aunt died at 19, and Russian forces arrested and charged my grandmother with collusion and sentenced her to 25 years of hard labor at the woman's strict regime prison in Mordovia, Russia. While in prison and at great personal risk, my grandmother began embroidering religious icons at night by the light of the northern latitudes. She used cloth and threads from her clothes and fish bones for needles. It was these icons that kept her spirit alive during the hard years in the Gulag. In 1953, Stalin died, and in 1956, Nikita Khrushchev granted amnesty to political prisoners, such as my grandmother. Upon release, she smuggled the embroidered icons, which were strictly forbidden by Soviet authorities, out of the prison by sewing them into her clothes. When my grandmother finally returned to her hometown, she found herself all alone. After living in the displaced persons camp for 4 years, her family ended up in America. Unable to join them due to the Iron Curtain, she eventually began a censored correspondence with her husband and daughter, my mother. An American tourist successfully smuggled the embroideries to her family in the West. My grandmother passed away in 1975.